Last night's thunderstorm over the lake, what a spectacle.
I'm glad my barn's still standing, but thanks for calling in, Matt.
Let's see what the weather will bring today. We're starting the day with showers, but the sun might come back in the end. Enjoy the music.
Open up the window. I'm breathing in the last of September. can feel the wind blow. And the late summer sky is like a dying ember. Everything is turning into gold. When the autumn leaves are playing chases, puts a smile upon my face. They leave their branches one by one and whirl around there just for fun. Some are faster, some are slow, and some are high and some are low. Dancing through the last days of September. Since I was a little child, every year for as long as I remember, all the leaves were running wild, going all the way until November. Turn the one by one and whirl around there just for fun. Some are faster, some are slow, and some are high and some are low. Dancing through the last days of September. I wonder where they're going, the flight of swallows sailing through the sky. There's no way of knowing, but maybe someplace far from you and I. When the autumn leaves are playing chases, puts a smile upon my face. They leave their branches one by one and whirl around there just for fun. Some are faster, some are slow, and some are high and some are low. Dancing through the last days of September. When the autumn leaves trying to swear free. I'm just as bad as you, and sometimes worse, you see. But all this crazy, right? I'm looking for the breaks. Come join me in the search. I think that's what it takes.
Just wanna watch them stars fall with you, who don't wanna try to make up dreams just to be seen. I wanna lay here beside you, oh quiet. Fire breath and open sky, it's not what we know, it's where we go. I grow wings to tell her goodbye. Well, it's not what we see, it's what we choose to be. Sunflowers, high grass, and bare feet. Each second is a dream. I keep my balance next to you, it's true. Nowadays there's nothing I wouldn't do for you. Fire breath and open sky, it's not what we know, it's where we go. I grow wings and tell her goodbye. It's not what we see, it's what we choose to be. We're beyond good, I've never been so ready. Fire breath and open sky, it's not what we know, it's where we go. I grow wings and tell her goodbye. Oh, it's not what we see, it's what we choose to be. Fire breath and open sky, it's not what we know, it's where we go. I grow wings and tell her goodbye. It's not what we see, it's what we choose to be.
Oh. All right. So we will be doing more lake and then Amber Isle. Okay. Let's see.
All these busy people hurry.
Let's do this one. Here's your meal. Yeah. And I figured out, like, I could do a lot of autopiloting to get around, and it makes it very easy to make a lot of the deliveries. Well, because I'm really into playing this, but also Amber Isle is super cute, so nothing says I can't do both. I mostly, after getting my two shots yesterday, I would say the only issue, besides feeling a little more tired than normal, is my arm feels like somebody hit it with all their strength with a metal baseball bat. It hurts so bad. Like, I do not want to use my left arm. And that's why I made the right choice getting it in my left arm. Because I'm right-handed. Even just the slight readjustment of my arm like this. Ugh. Like, I regret doing that. And Angie is leaving. We hate her.
What's this? The Flick Shack has closed down and will not reopen.
Bye!
Return tapes can be dropped off before September 22nd. It has been a privilege to serve as Providence Oaks' premier home cinema provider.
Yeah, she, like, apologized for being a jerk face. And we accepted her apology because, like, that's the right thing to do. But also, we hate you, Angie. So. Oh, and I didn't even pick up the package. That's cool. Okay. How are you, Abir? Let's go. What is my... 105 East 2nd. Oh no, I'm sorry you've been sick, but I'm glad you're recovering. I hope you can do that if that's what you want to do. Two letters over this way.
Stop saying it's not a day, baby.
Okay, it is 102. I'm actually surprised the Meredith, you know what, I'm not gonna say anything. I don't know. She hasn't said anything, so nothing to say about anybody's mail today, I guess. Here you go, Nancy.
Are you here to help out with the camera?
Actually, no.
Well, this store has a large selection, but it doesn't include small
talk. Nancy, I don't like you. I just need to drop off the package. Like, what is your problem? Well, because I won't help out with the freaking photography shit. There we go.
Here's your mail.
Oh god, it's the crazy cat lady's house. Or is it? It's this one actually, it's not the crazy cat lady.
Leave it on the doorstep.
to the farm. Another fox. We'll be back, Diner. We'll be back. Here we are at the farm.
I eased out of bed just before sunrise. Grabbed my backpack and I was out the door. Wishing I could have seen the look in your eyes. Did I fly on that wall? Now I'm on the morning train down to Savannah.
Mail carrier Meredith.
Farmer Jack.
Good to see at least someone's working today.
As opposed to you?
Yep. Can't harvest taters with all this rain. Luckily, Frank's keeping me busy.
I'm not surprised.
Seems like you're getting to know him. He's mad as a wet hen. It's quite entertaining, actually. Thanks for dropping by, mail carrier Meredith. I gotta get back to it.
Isn't it well past harvesting season?
True enough, but something else is keeping me occupied.
And what's that?
Can't say, mail carrier Meredith, can't say. Have a good one.
Suspicious. All right. We've arrived at the diner. And then another day has been completed. Which...
Hi, Maureen.
P.O. people, I need to pause the music for a special message.
Hush, darling. I want to hear this. And so do you.
It's from our own Robert Harris, who wants to keep Providence Oaks pretty. Don't flatter yourself. He's talking about the trees. Take it away, Robert.
Dear people of Providence Oaks, I'm Robert Harris. I oppose the plans for new apartments on Lakeview Drive. If you feel the same, let Town Hall know about it. Give them a call. Let's keep Providence Oaks pretty.
Isn't that something? It could have been more juicy, I guess. But it does say exactly what he wants it to, which is rare for our Robert. Even though he does have his redeeming qualities, doesn't he just? I wonder how he came up with the idea, though.
Actually, I helped out a bit when he was recording it at Jack's studio.
Is that right?
It is.
I see. Robert wasn't kidding when
okay,
he said
Maureen.
He wants to keep pretty things around in Providence Oaks now, was he?
That's not exactly how he put it, and neither should you.
Well, that's what I heard. Anyway, I actually wanted to talk to you about something
else. The witchcraft
song. What are you doing this Sunday evening, hon?
Nothing yet, I think.
Well, I've got just the solution for you. Listen here. I'm hosting a very special first-time open mic night this upcoming Sunday. We'll have some drinks, some food, discover the town's hidden talent, or not, if you know what I mean. It'll be a hoot.
More like a hoot and a half. Count me in.
Good. I already had you down on my list, of course, but it's nice of you to RSVP. That's settled then. I will see you this Sunday at 8 p.m. And tell everyone you meet, okay? Let me see you put those postal delivery muscles to good use.
Let's just say I'll do my best.
There you go. You're catching up. Now I have to go unpack some deliveries out back, but I will see you soon, darling. And don't forget about the open mic.
I couldn't if I wanted to.
Look at Winnie in the corner. End the day. Hey, Slash. How you doing? Welcome on in.
Hello?
Hi, Meredith. It's me.
Oh, hi, Dad. What's up?
The sun is up. The sky is blue.
I love
blue.
How one of the
life's
responses was a joke about Alcoholics Anonymous. No thanks.
That's great to hear.
Yeah, we're so
yeah,
happy
not too
we
bad.
Finally
just
took the trip.
Chilling
Why
out, playing this game
Let
where I'm a mail carrier.
Well, excuse me, Mrs. Weiss. Meredith, sorry to break it up. Your mom wants to talk to you.
Meredith, I'm so excited. Your dad and I found this cottage this weekend near the beach. Not too big, but who wants to be inside anyway?
I might. I have, what movie is it tomorrow?
Wow, that sounds great. What's the plan? Live there?
Yes. We talked to the owner. We can rent it for the time being, spend the winter here. Like it, we can buy it and settle down here for good.
Wow, that's quite a big step. Life-changing and all that.
Isn't it something? And it means that our house will be vacant for a while. We won't put it on the market until we've tried out Florida for a few months. So, if you want to extend your stay in Providence,
Are you serious?
I'm pretty serious, yes. But it's a pretty big deal, so just think about it for now.
Can I talk to her for a sec again?
Yeah, here comes your dad again. Bye, dear. I'm going to get a...
Yeah, I'll have to check those.
Hey, Meredith. Just wanted to say that I'll call again at the end of this week. Have a great
It's
one.
Also just hard because they're always right when I have to go and have an appointment. So...
Memories, memories, memories of you and me. Memories.
I don't know, guys. Do you think he's singing about
Mickey.
Memories?
That was so deep. Right, Meredith?
It's in the darkness when my soul stars align and illuminate the real me.
Oh, baby, I'm so happy for you.
We need to celebrate this moment. I'll be right back, ladies.
Mickey can be difficult sometimes, but nights like these... I wouldn't want to be anywhere else but with him.
And that's why you're following him all the way to Canada?
It's also that he needs me. He would get into trouble without me.
Is she interrogating you again, June?
Oh, Mickey. Be nice to sweet Meredith.
I'm just kidding now. Sorry for being a hard ass the other day, Meredith. It's just that we need to be a bit cautious.
It's okay, Mickey. I've had worse, delivering mail.
Delivering mail for the man? I couldn't do that.
So, you guys are sticking
it to the man.
Hell yeah, can't stand the man. Anything with authority, in whatever shape or form it appears.
I think I know what you mean. Feeling like a prisoner of society.
Hey, guys. Let's not spoil this evening with heavy stuff, okay?
Ah, you're so right, Junebug. Who cares about the man when I've got you?
Yeah, stick it to the man.
Something that'll make you feel lighter? Much lighter.
Oh, yeah.
Meredith!
I can't. I'm a postal worker.
No, thanks. I'll pass.
June?
Maybe later, Mickey. Meredith, how about some booze instead?
I'm allowed
sure.
to do
what
that.
What do you have?
Beer, wine, and whiskey.
Wine, please.
Gotcha. Be right back.
Drinking wine around a campfire. Listen to the sky sing about memories.
Memories. Memories. Of you. And me. Memory.
Alrighty, here you go.
Oh my God. So are you guys on the run?
So, are you guys on the run?
What can I say? We've got a few... unpaid parking tickets. Mickey had an argument with some cop, and then there's a bit of college and tax debt. Nothing major. So we're not really on the run. It's more like speed walking.
How
are you guys gonna cross the border?
It's so exciting. Damien will pick us up with his Jeep tomorrow morning. We'll have a cozy hour under the blankets when we cross the border. And then we're good. Hey, I just realized we're abandoning the RV. You should totally have it. Mickey, can Meredith have the RV?
That piece of junk? Knock yourself out.
Let me ask this. Is this stolen?
I don't know. Is it even yours to give away?
Technically, no. But the owner's a good guy. We'll square it with him. Don't worry.
Whatever you decide, we'll leave it at the gas station. That's where we rendezvous with Damien.
Wild.
Memories, memories, memories of you and me. Memories.
Oh my God. I was gonna say, if I have to hear this man sing about memories one more time, I'm gonna lose it.
Top of the third.
Bless you.
Morning, P.O. We don't have any callers today, so I'll bring up one of my own pet peeves.
P.O. Positive or pet peeve?
The idiotic plans for pedestrianization of Main Street. It's... Well, don't get me started or I won't even have time for the weather. Speaking of, a few clouds early on, but they will be gone soon. Music time!
Okay. Can I have a steak sauce? Can I also have some melted butter? Thank you. Bingo.
These look like bills.
Meredith, mind your business.
trying to swear free. Just as bad as you, and sometimes worries you see. But all this crazy, right? I'm looking for the breaks. Come join me in the search. I think that's what it takes. Oh.
socks and bare feet. Oh, but you each second is a treat. I keep my balance next to you. It's true. Nowadays there's nothing I wouldn't do. By your breath and open sky, it's not what we know, it's where we go. I grow wings and tell her goodbye. It's not what we see, it's what we choose to be. We're beyond good. I've never been so ready. Fire breath and open sky. It's not what we know, it's where we go. I grow wings and tell her goodbye. Oh, it's not what we see, it's what we choose to. Fire breath and open sky. It's not what we know, it's where we go. I grow wings and tell her goodbye. It's not what we see, it's what we choose to.
Down south.
Packed up, ready to leave. Everybody here is waiting for something, but I'll be on my way. I'll make it there by New Year's Eve. Stop dragging your myself a job well in Chicago. It's not too much to go on, but I'll make it fine. Ooh, still anything's better than just hanging around, yeah. Stop dragging.
it out, what you're putting in. All your hopes and efforts are all in vain.
All right, we're back.
When you've lost everything,
I do have some laundry going, so in 35 minutes-ish, I will need to go do that and swap it over, but that's okay. Up, oh well. Let's do this one.
No answer.
These look like bills.
Meredith. Mind your business.
All these busy people hurrying along. If they're not on the phone, they're all worried something's wrong. Making it important to be the first in line. So when the cookie crumbles, the best piece they will find. Oh, we're racing to
a sight for sore eyes.
Oh, hi, Miss Jenkins. How so? Are you expecting more mail from your son?
It's just... this week, it's all a bit much for me. I need to get my hair done for Sunday's special evening, but I can't leave my cats alone. And then all of a sudden, Frank has gone missing. He still needs to bring me an envelope. Please tell me that you have it with you.
I'm afraid this is just a postcard. But what do you mean he needs to bring you an envelope?
Oh, don't be a nosy posy, Meredith. Oh, dear, he can't just have vanished into thin air, can he?
Maybe he can, I don't know.
Don't worry, I'm sure Frank will show up again.
Oh, Frankie boy, always making me worry too much. And I need to cancel the hairdresser's appointment, but what if I can't reschedule?
Oh, don't worry about it. Your hair looks just fine.
No. My hair looks like a mess. I can't go out and about looking like this.
Sure you can, Miss Jenkins. I'm sorry, but I have to be on my way again.
Oh, dear. I need to go inside and calm down a bit.
Got a package. Oh, there's... Oh.
Meredith! Look at this house on wheels. I have no idea where it came from, but it's absolutely rad.
It was left here by Mickey and June, that young couple by the lake campground.
Oh, really? And now what?
They told me I could have it if I want. And I think I want it. If I can let it stay here for a while. You can tinker on it, too.
You know I'd love tinkering, but it's going to need a lot of work. It can stay here for as long as you need.
Good to hear, Lori. I can already hear the cogs in your head spinning at top speed. What are your plans?
Well, if it's going to be here a while, I should give it a name first. Can't have such a beautiful vehicle and not give it a name. How about the Sea Turtle? Big, slow, washed up, just like a turtle, or the raccoon, because it's got brown spots and is full of trash, or the hermit shell. It had many owners over the years, just like the shell of a hermit crab.
I like the sea turtle.
Good choice. I'll get working on it right away. See you later.
Bye.
So it looks like I think I have to play through till Sunday, and then I think that's the end of the game, which I'm not gonna get to today. And I'm kind of torn because I want to play Amber Isle, but I'm also feeling pretty tired. There it is. Oh.
Ah, yes, yes, yes. He could only look on in sheer terror as Madeline threw the key straight into the lake. Oh, yes. This is good stuff.
Excuse me, sir?
Oh, for Christ's sakes, go away. If I've told you once, I've told you 1,000 times.
You haven't told me anything. I'm new here.
Oh, bloody heck. Do I sound like I care? You lot are all the same to me. Just go away. How many yokels are there in this backwater town? Do they realize people come out to these kinds of places because they're supposed to be remote and quiet?
Sir, if you don't want to be disturbed, don't mail order anything.
I do beg your pardon. Yes, I am expecting a package. I didn't know you were from the Postal Service, ma'am.
Should it even matter who I am? Shouting at random strangers is generally considered rude.
All right, I'm sorry. It's just, I've been under a lot of pressure lately from my publisher, as well as my wife. I do appreciate your driving all the way up here, and Lord knows I'll be needing those ribbons. Just please leave them on the porch, and thank you.
You're welcome, sir.
All right. Now, where was I? She threw the key in the lake. Then what happens? Oh, Christ's sake, she made me lose my bloody train of thought. No, wait, I got it. And then he says,
let the autopilot take me back.
Yeah.
Good afternoon, Miss Weiss.
Good afternoon, Mr. Morgan.
Yikes.
I wanted to let you know that today
it.
Was my last day here.
Oh, really? Will Frank be coming back then?
That's all I have to say.
Yeah.
Good luck.
Because you could do lighthouse to shoreline to customs to factory to woods. And then...
Hello?
Hi, Em. It's me, Kay.
Oh, hi, Kay.
Good, you're home. Listen, I don't know if you're busy tonight, and I wouldn't normally bother you like this, but I'm kind of in a huge pickle at the moment, and now I'm imagining being inside of a huge pickle. Thanks, brain.
Sure, what's up?
Okay, so this is going to sound like I'm 16, but I have these tickets to a really big concert tonight for Barry and me, and it seems the babysitter has just bailed on me. All right, so maybe the babysitter part doesn't sound like I'm 16, I hope. Anyway, it's Journey, so I'm like, I need to go tonight, and I got these tickets ages ago. And it's a long drive to Portland, so we'll probably be out all night, and I promise you I've called everyone and their brother. Besides, they're really good kids to watch tonight.
Whoa, 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 whoa. Can I get a shortcut to the question?
Yeah, sorry. You're totally right. I'm blabbering on R&I. Okay, don't freak out. You got this. All right, recap. Journey tonight, in Portland, got tickets, sitter bailed. So I guess you figured out by now that I'm awkwardly trying to ask if maybe you could do me a huge favor and watch Grace and Max tonight?
Hey, it's fine. Don't worry. I'll babysit tonight.
Oh my god, you serious? That would help me out in such a big way.
I don't know these kids.
Big time. Huge.
No problem. So, what time do you need me?
You're a lifesaver. As soon as you can make it. You don't have to bring anything. There's food, videos, even a cardboard replica of Apollo 11 with a set of matching helmets. You're covered. See you in a bit.
All right. See ya.
Well, we don't have to.
All right. Who wants s'mores?
S'mores? We're in...
Hey, hey, hey! Guess who's back?
Frank? I'm so glad to see you again.
I'm so happy to be here again. I guess Morgan didn't stick around to welcome me back.
Good riddance.
Hell yeah, that clueless piece of work.
What happened the last few days?
Well, what can I say? Don't mess with the big boys. I guess they didn't understand that some of my customers do a little more than talking about their cats.
Ooh, this sounds very juicy.
Frank Coleman's no stranger to the high-stakes game. I've got lawyers in my inner circle. All it took were a couple of lawsuit threats.
But Frank, isn't this all just really
I don't know.
Wrong?
Nah, Meredith. It's just a bit of harmless fun.
Just crime.
Okay, Frank, if you say so.
All right. Time to get back in the saddle. Have a great day, Meredith.
Just Jason Nash casually or in a monitor.
music on the menu is nice. I like it. I thought you'd like to know as early as possible. I have nothing to teach you. Yep. I tell you all I know. Yeah, we did. I remember this from last salads. Buddy. Yeah. I literally offered 8. Why is this bugged? I already did. I already started it. It'll be done in 4.5 minutes. Too hard. There aren't many like those two at Orb Corp, so I'm adding to the management manual on a daily basis. But I'm not blind. I know Maple and Clawsworth don't seem to like Orb Corp, but I just want to help them. I mean, we all want the same things, to restore Amber Isle to its former glory, or even better. And I've got so many ideas, I think that's why Orb Corp sent me here. They actually think I'm good at something. This is my chance to prove it and earn a sore name just that actually feels like me. I know some paleofolk take their family names, but I have 8 siblings, so it doesn't really feel like mine, you know? I'll earn my own name, and I'll do it by making a place where everyone feels noticed. Like you've made me feel by coming here tonight. You don't have to say it back, but I feel like we might be becoming friends. Of course we're friends. You might be the first friend I've made since working for Orb Corp. I think I've slept at my desk long enough now, Steffi. Maybe we should both hit the hay. Thank you. It's nice to talk to someone else about all this. Return to my shop. Okay. I will be back tomorrow with more paleo folk and Amber Isle. That is the best way to do this.